Hello everyone, welcome to this new video. In this video, I am going to explain how to deploy the Bold Reports report server in Docker. To start with, the Bold Reports report server is an application that provides organizations with an easy and cost-effective way to add reporting capabilities to their existing infrastructure without requiring any development effort. With the report server, we can create, manage, and share reports easily without having to write any code. One of the major benefits of the report server is that it can be deployed on premises or in the cloud, providing flexibility to organizations to choose a deployment option that suits their needs. Now let me show the requirements for deploying the Bold Reports report server on Docker. Starting with the hardware requirements. The CPU should be 4 core, the memory should be 16 GB of RAM, and the disk space should be 8 GB or more. For software requirements, Docker should be installed. You should have a database available, such as Microsoft SQL Server 2012 or higher, PostgreSQL, or MySQL. Make sure your database is accessible outside the machine too. You should have a web browser, such as Microsoft Edge, Mozilla Firefox, or Google Chrome. And you should have one of these operating systems. Now, let's jump into the demo. I am going to use the Ubuntu system for this demo, connected through Git Bash for the deployment. Docker is already installed with this system. Let's start the deployment. Create the folder with the name Bold Reports. And move to the Create folder using Linux commands. Then download the docker_compose.yml from GitHub using this command. Next, download the default.conf file by running this command. I have provided the GitHub link in the description below. In this demo, I'm going to deploy the report server using the public IP address. I open the docker_compose.yml file using Vim editor to update the deployment information. And change the value of app base URL with my IP address along with the port number under the environment section. You can use any other open port available. If you want to use third-party data sources like MySQL, Oracle, and PostgreSQL in your report, then you need to install them while deploying the report server. For that, uncomment the install optional libs line. Next, change the reverse proxy information to use our configuration available with default.conf. In the reverse proxy section, replace the default.conf path with /default.conf, since the .conf file is available in the current folder. Here, you need to use the same port number you provided in the app base URL. If you are hosting the report server in the domain, you need to configure the SSL information for a secure connection. By default, the application will be hosted in non-SSL mode. To configure the SSL, in the docker_compose.yml file in the reverse proxy section, we need to uncomment SSL cert file path and SSL key file path in the volumes section, and provide the certificate and key file path. Then we need to comment 8085:80. Uncomment 443:443 in the port section. And make sure our app base URL is HTTPS. Next, open the default.conf file. We need to uncomment these lines. Since I am hosting my server using my IP address, I am not doing that. Next, replace example.com with your domain name. And then you need to comment out this line. Now all the configurations are completed. Next, we are going to create the Docker image by using Docker Compose with updated YML configuration files. We run this command. This command runs in detached mode, which pulls the needed Docker images and starts the Bold Reports and database containers. Then I run this command to check the status of each container. Here you will see all the images are running. You can open the application by entering the value in the app base URL. It will open the application startup page. First, we need to activate the Bold Reports account either by using online credentials or by uploading the offline unlock key. You can download the unlock key from your Bold Reports accounts page and upload it here. For this demonstration, I am going to activate it by using online credentials. I click Login to activate the account and enter my Bold Reports credentials. Since I have only one portal license, the portal license selection process was skipped in this setup. If you have more than one portal license, you'll need to select one. Next, I will configure the administrator user by entering the user information and password. Then I click the Next button. Here we can configure the database to store the report server data. You can store reports in the SQL Server, PostgreSQL, or MySQL databases. I choose PostgreSQL for this demo, and the fields will be reloaded based on the selected database. I provide the necessary information in the required fields. You can create a new database or use an existing database in the selected server type. I choose New Database. And I provide the database name Bold Services Docker. Then I turn on the Enable SSL option to make a secure connection using SSL. I click the Next button. The report tenant deployment has started and will run in the background. Next, click Go to Reports. And we are redirected to the View All page. Here, the sample reports that are already available with the report server can be added by clicking Explore in the Report Sample pop-up. You will see the list of samples already available. By clicking the Add Report button, you can add these reports to the report server. The reports will be added under the Sample Reports category. Clicking on an added report will open it in the report server. The final configuration of the Bold Reports report server with visualization items such as charts and gauges will not be available for exporting. To export data visualization report items when scheduling reports, we need to install the PhantomJS client library in our report server. PhantomJS is a headless WebKit scriptable with JavaScript. Let's see how to install it. First, though, we need to bash our container. We need to open the Docker CLI of the Bold Reports container. Run this command to get the container ID. Here, open the CLI of id_web_container by running this command. This references the container ID. Now we are inside the container. Next, move to the optional library folder. Now the current directory is changed to /application/app_data/optional_libs. Then, install the sudo and wget. Next, we have to install some required packages before we can install PhantomJS. Run this command. Next, download the latest stable version of PhantomJS from the official website by running this command. Once the download is complete, extract the downloaded archive file to the desired system location by running this command. It will extract the downloaded file and move it to the /usr/local/share directory. Next, create a symlink of the PhantomJS binary file to the system's bin directory by running this command. Verify whether PhantomJS is installed properly or not by running this command. If it shows the version number, then PhantomJS is installed properly. Reload the browser and export the report that has charts. Open the exported file and you will see the charts are exported. In this video, we had a basic introduction to the report server, covered the steps to deploy it on Docker, and then saw how to add optional client libraries. Lastly, we installed PhantomJS in the deployed application to export the data visualization report items when scheduling. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.